Hello friends, welcome to a new chapter today. In biochemistry, we are going to learn today about the amino acids. Okay, in the amino acids, if you see, first I will tell you the general structure of amino acids. C, H, and there will be a functional group attached. This is an aliphatic chain, and there are two functional groups which come under amino acids. For amino acids, it should have a carboxyl group which is attached to the right side, whereas it should have an amine group which is attached to the left side. So if you actually look at this here, this carbon atom has four different types of compounds are attached to this carbon atom. So this carbon atom can be called as asymmetric carbon atom. Because it is asymmetric carbon atom, it can exhibit optic isomerism and also structural isomerism. It can exert both optic isomerism and structural isomerism. But I told you that this is asymmetric. Fine. Is there any amino acid which is not asymmetric? Yes, we have glycine. Glycine is an amino acid. It contains NH2 group or amino group on the left side, and it also contains a bicarbonate group on the right side. But it has two hydrogen atoms which are attached to the carbon atom. This is the simplest amino acid, and it has no optic isomerism or it has no structural isomerism. Right? So once we have seen we will see the carbon classification. See, this is the COOH group attached, and in an amino acid we can have any number of carbon atoms, right? So the carbon atom which is just beside this carboxyl group is called as alpha amino acid. After that, the second carbon atom is beta, then gamma. Alpha amino acids, that is, if amine group, see, this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon, this is called as gamma carbon. If an amine group is attached to this alpha carbon, then we call it as alpha amino acid. If an amine group is attached to this beta carbon, then we call it as beta amino acid. If it is attached to the gamma carbon, then we call it as gamma amino acid. Among all these, the alpha amino acid is the one which is most common. But are there any non-alpha amino acids? Yes, the non-alpha amino acids include, we have two compounds which belong to non-alpha amino acids, which are beta alanine, beta amino isobutyrate, and we have gamma amino butyrate. We have beta alanine, beta amino isobutyrate, and gamma amino butyrate. Right? Now, the most common amino acids most commonly are present in L form of isomerism. Except we have two D forms. That is, we have D serine and we also have D aspartate. This D serine and D aspartate amino acids are present in the brain. Then there is a nomenclature which is called as amino acids or amino acids. So what are these amino acids? So if you see, we also have amino acids. These amino acids, actually they have, this is COOH, right? Carboxyl group. Okay, there is COO minus, right? And this is the alpha carbon. And to this alpha carbon, there is a hydrogen bond attached. And also, this alpha carbon, there is a ring structure which is attached to this alpha carbon. So, this alpha carbon has a ring structure which is attached. So, this is called as amino acid. Actually, this ring which is attached, if you see this ring which is attached to this amino acid, this ring, there is a name for this ring which is called as pyrrolidine ring. This pyrrolidine ring is an alpha amino. It is also an alpha amino acid because the NH2 group is attached to the alpha carbon. And this is example of this pyrrolidine ring or amino acid is proline. Proline is an amino acid. Okay. So this is the introduction of amino acids. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.